Welcome back everyone. Today, we will create this nice customer insight dashboard, from data we have placed on Kaggle for you. We will create buckets using data analysis expression. And we will export some icons from PowerPoint, and use them here. We will also learn to turn on map visuals, which are disabled by default. And we will see how we can change the size of our canvas, and use grid lines to accurately place visuals. So without any further delay, let's start our tutorial. We have already placed the data on Kaggle, which you can download from here. You can click on the download button, to download the file. The zip file contains a CSV file, which we will extract, and place in a folder. We can use the Get Data menu, to connect to a CSV file. So we select the file, and click on the Open button. This will load a preview window, where we can review the data, and if everything looks alright, we can load the data. The data is loaded, all the tables, and their respective columns, are available in the data pane, which we can use to create visualizations. For the purpose of accuracy and precision, we will turn on the Snap to Grid, and Grid Lines options. We can also have a custom size for our dashboard. In Canvas settings, we can define any size we want. We just have to select custom, and change height and width to our liking. However, the default size is perfect for most computers. Therefore, we will keep the default size for our canvas. Now, let's add a title to our dashboard, by inserting a text box, from the Insert menu. Now, let's go to the table view. And add a new column. We will call the column Age Buckets. We will use the if conditions, to create four age buckets. The first age bucket will contain all the customers below 25 years of age. The second bucket will contain all the customers with age between 25 and 35. The third bucket will contain all the customers having age between 35 and 45. And the final bucket will be of customers with age more than 45. Press Enter to apply the DAX function. And there you go. Now we have a column with age buckets. Now, we will create another buckets column, for rating. First we will group all customers having rating, less than 3. The next bucket will group customers, having rating between 3 and 5. Another bucket will group customers with rating between 5 and 7. And finally, customers with above 7 rating. Now that we have both age and rating buckets, we can go back to the report view, and create some nice visuals. First, let's add a bar chart. Turn on the visual borders for title text box. We will add the age buckets to y-axis and the customer lifetime value to x-axis. Remove extra words from axis title. We will also add visual borders to our chart. We will use the same chart to create a visual for customer lifetime value by rating buckets. We will just replace the age buckets with rating buckets. Similarly, we will duplicate this chart, change it to pie chart, and replace field in legend with marital status. Finally, we will create a visual for gender by displaying customer lifetime value by gender. Now we will add some geographic information to our dashboard by adding a map chart. Add the location field to the location area and the CLV field to the bubble size area. At this point, if your map does not appear, you must enable maps in your settings. Go to the security settings. Look for the checkbox about using maps and fill maps and check it. Now refresh the data to display the map visual. Go to the Home tab and click on the Refresh button. Wait for the refresh process to take place. Maps should now work fine. Turn on the visual borders for our map chart as well. Duplicate an existing bar chart and place it in the bottom right corner. Now change it to a line and column chart. Move the CLV field from column y-axis to line y-axis. Add the date field to x-axis, keeping only the months. Now, add the average order value to the column y-axis as average. We need some icons, which we can get from PowerPoint. Use the search bar to look for your desired icons. Now we have some gender icons. Let's choose one male and one female icon and save them as picture. We will save them as PNG files. After saving both files, we will add them to our Power BI dashboard. From Insert tab, select Image. And then select one of the icons. Similarly, we will add the other icon as well. Now we will add a card to our dashboard and add the gender field to the values area as count. Then we will remove the category label and place it below the female icon. We will duplicate this card and place it below the male icon. We will add the gender field to the filters and select male only. We will do the same to the other card and select female only. Now we have total male and female customers, indicated by some nice icons above them. Finally, we will add a text box to our dashboard. We will turn on its visual borders and make it fully transparent. Then we will place it around the male-female counts. This will act as a border for our male-female counts and their icons. And with this we end our tutorial. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more insightful tutorials and updates.